You hear that? Can you hear that? That's what I was doing. I was rubbing my hands together in anticipation. Because I am hyped, baby. I am hyped. This is the Pro Wrestling Potluck, the live weekly wrestling mixtape that I host, me. I am your host, and hey, we're friends. Let's be friends. I'm Scotland Green. God dang it, we got a good one. We got a humdinger and a goddanger. And I invented that term. If you hear anyone else say goddanger, they owe me 75 cents. Either way, we got a good one tonight.
Attention, Owen Straw.
Okay, oh, Sarge is in the house. Owen Straw, Cool Dude Food is in the house. We got a good one tonight. I have coughed up the money to pay for Zoom, legitimate Zoom. No longer will I be afraid of the time limit or, you know, usually if you followed this show, when I have calls, I have to put them right at a certain point in the show, you know. This is all show. This is all show, baby cakes. If you have a story about a wrestling fan you set by that was a nutcase, call in. We're going to be doing calls all throughout the night. If I see there's a call in the waiting room, we'll take that call right after the match or right after whatever segment. I'm trying to do calls all over this show. It's going to be experimental. I'm trying to get this show to the version that lives in my head. We're going to have a great one. So yeah, get in the Zoom if you got a call. I got some stories to tell about weird wrestling fans. Is there anything else we want to do before we start the proper show? I don't think so. I think we're going right to it. We are going right to it. I posted on Twitter. Everyone knows I stopped Twitter in August, but I have crept back just to post about this show and then run away. And I saw that Mr. T was trending, and I thought the worst. I was like, oh my God, Mr. T is trending. Do I need to redo this show right now? I don't. He's fine. He's fine. He took the COVID vax, and everyone's mad at him for it or some shit. But God bless Mr. T. He loves his mama. All right. We're doing this right. Let's start it.
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further. Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
The most. This is going to be pulse-pounding spectacle from start to finish.
All right.
Take your eyes off this for
Pro
a second.
Pro Wrestling Noah, Buzz, Ben. We saw
well,
these four guys
match,
in a four-way, and now they're in a tag that I've heard so much great stuff about.
He's got the tassels to go with it as well.
We did not pick my poison. I will talk about that.
As they go in for gold today, the vacant THE Junior Heavyweight Tag
we got
Team
Alpha
titles.
Wolf yes. And right. Dragon Bane, or as I like to call him, D Bane and A Wolf, teaming up against Ninja Mac and Alejandro.
When you've got
or as I like to say, Alejandro.
Alejandro. In a match together. Expected car crush.
Yep. Just brace yourself.
Yeah.
Now.
Just brace yourself. Of the
we
four competitors in this match, only Ninja Mac
weeks ago,
has held Noah Gold
and,
before G-Man.
I put it up
that
on. I put the show up on YouTube, and
it
was
held
fine.
For 11 days.
And I had a comment in the comment
right.
Section
his first defense
from
Dante
Ninja
Leo.
Mac himself. Ninja
these
Mac watched
men,
the potluck. I guess
in this
I didn't have
in
match
this
listings
week.
On the episode, so he had to have gone through my Instagram when I tagged him on the match. Listings. Yeah. Either
in
way,
the ring,
Ninja
the
Mac
Alpha
watched the
Ninja
show
Mac,
and commented
basis,
yeah. in the thing. And,
raising the game.
And of course,
delivering,
my first thought when I see that Ninja Mac
matches.
Knows this
has.
Show exists
oh,
was,
now.
I should ask him to do the show.
Alejandro takes the back.
And then I remembered I did clown on him. I did clown
Alejandro.
On him. A little bit. I love Ninja Mac. If you're watching this, Ninja Mac, I clowned on you because you didn't wear a mask for a short period. But we love you, Ninja Mac. We'd love for you to do the show. And I will reach out to Ninja Mac.
Jumping back.
Why not?
And Alejandro
why not?
Up to his feet. Incredible, breathless action here. Double drop kick.
All right, here we go. Starting off
vertical base.
Dragon Bane and Alejandro.
You're only going to see this type of action in pro wrestling, Noah.
And this is just the start.
Yeah. Handshake. It's mutual respect, you're aplenty. He wants to get a ninja chant going. That's not going to take long.
I think everybody in the chat was a perfect angel.
Here comes the Mac.
But I did say that without his mask, he looked like a manager of a Piggly Wiggly.
What are you betting on?
But, you know, I say the same thing about my friend.
I'm not a betting man, especially in this.
Hulkster Jeff is in the house. Hulkster Jeff, how in the world are you doing? Welcome. Welcome.
Ninja Mac's got it all to do. And don't think that Ninja Mac necessarily outpaces Alpha Wolf.
Ooh, Alejandro.
Yeah, just ran up the body of Alpha Wolf.
Oh, no, that's Ninja Mac. My fault. God damn it, now I'm in big trouble.
Alpha Wolf tries to roll him up. Misses with a high kick. Ninja Mac with the back on Alpha Wolf. But that's
come on, we got to get Ninja Mac on this show to play wrestler or lead string.
Ninja Mac spins over back to his feet. It's a stalemate.
All right. Ninja Mac in the green, the Noah Green.
The second rope, moonsault back onto his feet. Looks for the pump kick. Ninja Mac looks to kick his own.
Oh, Sir Jeff, been a while. Hope everything is good.
He's too defiant.
Ooh, no effect.
Defying gravity at the moment, G-Man.
Wolf is not moving. And look at this exchange going on right now.
Drop kick, that floors Wolf. This match has got it all.
Yeah, we'll play Unmasked Wrestler or Piggly Wiggly in play.
And then some.
Why am I making it worse?
Knee onto the chest.
I love Ninja Mac. Can I not say that enough?
Ninja first.
I love Ninja Mac.
Alejandro.
Alejandro. Boom.
Alpha Wolf is down. Ninja Mac.
Ooh-wee.
Corkscrew press.
Oh my God, Alejandro.
Right on Wolf's
head. Hit like a brick right there.
Absolutely no margin of error on that. Double super kick sends down Dragon Bane.
D-Bane.
Table, G-Man.
What do you mean? What do you mean?
Hold on.
Alejandro!
Hero from Alejandro onto Alpha Wolf.
Alejandro.
Now Ninja Mac wants a piece of the action.
There oh, comes. Jesus
special.
Christ.
Ninja Special!
Look at that!
Holy
the Ninja Special!
He just wipes out the Mexican brothers, Los Golpeadores.
Carnage. Absolute carnage. Bodies everywhere.
Seamless offense.
You know what would be a fun subject on this show? One of those ranking things?
Both teams here
brother tag teams. We could rank some damn brother tag teams. There's so many.
Someone's going home with a goal.
Two-thirds of them are currently in AEW. Oh, listen to that.
The price of one.
He made his partner give him.
Ninja Mac, a DDT. He gave
him. Oh.
Springboard, double handspring elbow from the Dragon.
The Dragon, D-Bane, Dragon
Wolf
Bane.
Dragon are on top right now in Nagoya. This is the second tilt at these titles. You remember that incredible contest G-Man against GLG's Tadasuke in Yohei. So months ago at the Rock and Hall main event.
Like a human highlight reel.
Absolutely was, wasn't it? Leg lariat from Alpha Wolf. Dragon Bane off his brothers. Back.
Oh, now.
Into the corner.
I want Ninja Mac and Alejandro to win this match.
Yeah.
Only brothers would know.
Yeah.
You watch this now, watch this.
Oh my God, he flattened him. Wolf, he launched him right into Alejandro and flattened him.
Drags Alejandro to the center of the ring. Ninja Mac there to make the save. You know, they've been
Alpha Wolf
going
is
for those
scary.
20 years.
That's a together. Scary looking dude.
Family growing up in Mexico in that household. Now they're doing it on the big stage. Double super kick.
Oh, wow, look at that. Yeah,
Hulkster Jeff.
Alpha Wolf.
God bless you. You're preaching to the choir here. I
so smooth,
I feel the same way. I had a whole big rant on this show about it. AEW Fight Forever broke my heart.
There we go. Keep your eye on Wolf.
Springboard moonsault. Dragon.
Watch this.
Oh,
watch
my
this
God. Holy shit. Moonsault. What?
He's not done
these guys
yet.
Are insane.
Assisted shooting star press.
Oh, wrong brother.
What appreciating there, Boss
Alejandro got
really
in
good
there.
Awareness there. All that excitement. Perhaps getting a bit overzealous there. Los Golpeadores. You're in full control now.
Wolf is huge. Yeah, man, all you gotta do is tell me it's an updated version of the AKI engine, and I go right there. That's how you could lure me into a trap.
Nothing better than
tell
fighting
me there's a,
your brother and
an
against
AKI,
your brother.
Yeah. Modern
your brother.
Day AKI, yeah. AKI engine at Billy the bottom of the well.
Yeah. The Goya as well. This is gonna be watched around the world. Noah is developing a strong fan base, of course, in Mexico. Many luchadors you're going to see in the arc. Finest here, pro wrestling Noah. Alejandro second to the corner then. Dragon Bane is denied.
Yeah, I love
so
the fighting style in the game is great, but it's just so limited in 2023.
Now keep your eye on Bane. Wow, takes out Alejandro.
Yeah. Alejandro is getting out of danger, though, and he's regrouping alongside Ninja Mac. Alpha Wolf, though, between the first and second rope.
Uh-oh.
Somehow kicked them both on that one.
Yeah, the guardrail is moving. He can't make that distance. No way, G-Man.
Now I got to play that. Look at this.
This can't happen.
What, both of them?
Everybody's getting ready to catch this.
No. Oh, my God almighty.
Launched by his brother. Yes.
He went
that is
flying.
The greatest stunt victim hero I've ever seen, G-Man.
You are pulling my wig.
Wow.
I cannot believe it. Victor Meldrew.
He almost touched the ceiling.
Wow, just like that.
The Congress Center.
Air traffic control.
Now that's a run-in. A run-in from Hulkster
this
Jeff.
Match.
Good to see
my
you.
My goodness.
Wow, that was insane. How about a replay? Wow.
Astonishing offense from the brothers.
Three. Wow, we are starting off hot.
But then they just
we
raised
got a
the
way
stakes.
To start
indeed,
off. I could have ended with this match
level.
If I wanted
only
to.
Only they can do that, G-Man.
Yeah, like Necro Eric was saying, this show is full of good matches.
You're witnessing one
it's hard
right
to
now.
Pick what to put on this
we needed
show
the sky
as far
camera,
as Buzz
didn't
goes, which I'll talk about later.
We needed the jib, the drone.
Look at this.
The blimp, everything.
Yeah, the dragon's poised. The wolf is poised. Who's song the wolf? 450 splash, Dragon.
Double pin, this could be it.
Two.
Both kick out.
Yeah. Mexican style there, Lucha Libre style. Both men going for the pinfall attempt. Only one is the legal man, of course, here.
There you go. I got that ugly QR code on the screen.
The
if you feel like it.
These three.
If you got a call, God dog it, I want to hear you.
David.
If there's anybody in the waiting room, I'll take a call
elimination
right after
matches,
this match.
Six-man tag matches.
And here we are.
Yeah, these three are real GIF makers' dream, aren't they?
Right in the chest of Ninja Mac.
No dos tres. Oh, Ninja.
Blocks them both.
Two shoulders to block it.
Ooh.
Sends back Dragon Bane.
Ninja Mac fighting off the brothers.
Left boot blocks. Dragon Bane shots the body now. Ninja style.
Indeed. And now Ninja. Still need that momentum. Alejandro back in now. The Green Brothers, we'll say.
Yep. The Green Brothers. Hey now. That's me and
the
Tom.
Green attack in the Emerald Arc.
Me and Tom Green.
First,
Tom, you can catch
it Ninja
every
Mac.
Tuesday night.
Switching
he does
corners
WCW
now.
WCW, deep
here
cuts.
We go.
They watch C&D shows, full shows usually. It's a
Alejandro.
Great time. I'm there when I can be. Great chat. If you like this, you'll like that. I
dangerous.
Would check him out Tuesday
here we
night.
Go. Mac.
We are the
Bootleg
over.
Brothers. Rolls through.
Ninja Mac rolling and...
What on earth is going on here? Alejandro.
Arm drag.
And Mac chopping Dragon Bane here.
Yeah, he's beaten to the punch, wasn't he? The Mexican.
Hey, wait,
get him,
Mac. Wait a minute. We've seen this before.
Yeah,
this is what wiped out Hayatama.
Exactly. Ninja special.
Oh, my God.
Powerbomb attempt to the floor.
Alejandro.
And
an assist.
Powerbomb onto Alpha Wolf.
This
exactly
is
right,
really
G-Man.
Crazy.
That sunset flip powerbomb to the outside that injured Hayata at the elbow. And that's how Ninja Mac won the GHE Junior Heavyweight Championship.
By referee stoppage, no less.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
Shot for Ninja Mac. Alejandro with the fight back, though.
What's Alejandro doing now? Hey, what's this?
Oh, my
Bane.
God.
Don't
do it, Alejandro.
Do not. No, do not.
Flying
hedges.
Flying hedges into a super kick from Ninja
How
Mac.
How even come up with these spots?
Bane can be done for in this.
His toast is cooked.
This is like Tony Hawk.
Wolf. Could regret that. Here comes the wolf off the second rope. Now it's his turn. Arm drag onto the floor. And Ninja Mac lands on his feet.
Unbelievable.
Ninja Mac.
That sends down the wolf.
Sends down the
carnage.
Wolf.
Absolute carnage.
We wouldn't want it any other way, would we, G-Man?
No. As we said.
Dude, Ninja Mac is so fire, and since he's signed with Pro Wrestling Noah, he's like gotten even more crazy.
Here comes the Mac. Oh, looking for the Ninja Bob.
Hey, wait!
Moonsault misses. Now it's Alejandro up in the well. He made the tag as well there, G-Man.
Yes, Alejandro, legal man now.
Frog splash.
He nails it, he's got it. Alejandro and Mac.
Frog splash on the wolf, only for two. Alpha Wolf makes the tag, then brings in his younger brother, Dragon Bane.
Dragon Bane's in there now.
Here comes the Pain, here comes the Bane. Alejandro and Bane teeing off now. The chops. There, Bane assisted. Alejandro off the ropes with the arm drag. Pops up Bane.
Wolf goes for a ride. And now look at that! Stunning,
God! Spanish fly from Dragon Bane. How do you keep up with these four men?
Alejandro's going for a ride now.
Super kick onto the jaw of Dragon. Here's one from Alpha Wolf. Alejandro now.
Oh, what?
He's going downtown. Wait, no.
Oh, he's right on his ass. Out.
He was looking for the Wolf driver.
Here comes Wolf.
Oh, that then. Touch from Wolf.
Oh, no.
Hey, Wolf.
Whoa. Whoa. You're kidding me. You're kidding me.
Look out, Dragon Bane.
Everyone's getting turned inside out here.
Now it's ninja time. Headbutt from Alpha Wolf. Boot to the face from Alejandro. Big running knee from Dragon Bane. All four men are down.
Look at that. Look at that.
Thunderous applause from the Nagoya crowd.
Beautiful. This is crazy.
My goodness. That's what it's all about, folks. That's what it's all about. Yep. GHC Junior Heavyweight Tag Team Championships on the line, and they are leaving it all in the ring.
Is this, are the titles vacant, or is somebody the champion right now? Someone tell me, please. I skipped the intro.
GHC gold for the first time in their young careers.
For time, because we are
who
tight
is
in time,
walking
baby.
Out of Nagoya, GHC Junior Heavyweight Tag Team Champions.
Where's Wolf going here? He's joined Ninja Mac on the apron.
Yeah, I gotta know if it's Ann New or
come
if it's
Wolf says
still.
The ninja.
Somebody tell me. I guess I'll know when they say
whoa.
It.
Oh my God. Cool, blimey.
About get him, Mac. Come out for Wolf. Ninja time. There's a ninja chop.
There's a ninja
he
chop.
Can't match, though, surely. The ferocious offering from Alpha Wolf.
Ferocious offering is putting that in an impossible
title. I'm in arm condition just watching this.
Okay, double chop now from Ninja Mac. Still barely moves Alpha Wolf. Punishing Ninja.
Very good question.
Oh
shit.
Yeah. It was a headbutt.
Meeting of the minds.
Collision.
There was a knee then from Dragon Bane.
Dragon Bane picks up the pieces now. DDT on the apron, my goodness.
Yep.
God.
Hey, what's this now?
Wow.
Wolf with Mac.
Vacant.
No!
Wolf driver onto the
Wolf
apron.
Wolf driver. All right, so whoever wins, I get to press the and
Ninja
new
Mac.
Button. You
I'm
know
glad he's still moving.
And new
yeah,
button
Ninja Mac
here.
On the outside.
Keep your eye on Alejandro,
yeah.
though.
Wolf. Was admiring his handiwork. Now it's Dragon Bane spinning back kick to Alejandro.
Big old kick. D Bane and A Wolf.
What's this now? Bane and Wolf. Wolf! Wolf in the first round! Are you kidding me?
Took big suicida and then some from Alpha Wolf. Alejandro. DDT.
Oh, somehow
he
lives.
Land on his feet from that Dragon Bane. Looks to pop up Alejandro.
Oh,
that's like the Rey Mysterio special move.
No.
That's some Ray Psychosis shit right there.
Close call for Alejandro. Ninja Mac there.
This is incredible. My God.
You are
now we're opening
the
show.
Alejandro, top floor.
Kristen Corkscrew misses
no
with the flying bullets.
On the bed.
Dragon Bane up first. Misses with a big boot. Gonna look for a roll up, Alejandro.
Nice.
Yeah, here comes Wolf.
Wolf stops that.
Adios, Alejandro.
Big bad.
Oh no!
Oh my god!
Sent Alpha Wolf. Punching him over the top rope. Oh look, here comes the twister though from Dragon Bay. He's countered by Alejandro.
This could be it.
Just a two count.
Bay now. Alejandro slips out the back door, rolls him up.
Whoa, no
wait, what's this?
He's going to try and switch over here. Shoulders are down.
Oh. Two. Oh, no way.
Wow. Dragon Bane is loading him up for powerbomb.
Oh. E-Bane.
Bane rolling out onto the apron here. Alejandro in prime position here, Mark.
Yeah, this is heart pounding action for the call. What's Dragon Bane got in store now?
Dragon Bane on the top.
Shooting star press.
Hung in the air on that shooting star.
Hooks the leg, down with pressure. Two.
Do you.
No.
How did he kick out of that one?
What's it going to take, G-Man?
Elevator up. Alejandro in big trouble here.
Oh, my God.
Oh, right on his head.
That's got to be it.
Bane hooks the leg. New champion.
Wow. They've done it. The Mexican brothers, Los Golpeadores. Patrick, the only goal for the first time.
That was awesome. Wow, the brothers did it. KEMONITO in the news. This is a pro KEMONITO show. I don't know who that is. If you know who that is, he sees the flare go up, the flare that KEMONITO has shot in the air. He gets in his McLaren with the GTA 5 paint job. And now I think they're in a video game. It looks like a phone game. Now, this was sent in by Cool Dude Food, Owen Straw. Now, that is not Bull Nakano. That is Sakura Hirota, comedy wrestler, dressed like Bull Nakano. That ain't the real Bull. But that's the real Akira Hokuto. That's the real Akira.
Akira.
Bullshit Nakano is going on the list of possible titles next to Ferocious Operator.
なるほど。なるほど。素敵にはプロ様というぐらいの存在なんですか。本当。これはヒロチンドラッグの体勢を自らアピールしているが。ちょっと太もものポイントよりはお尻が痛くなるんじゃないかという。
ホクトに間違えされては広田さくらもなすすべがないか。この21世紀まずはブル中野、これはもじっと出てまいりました。瀬山さん、今日のこの後楽園ホール第1試合がですね、やや遅れたんですが、あの広田さくらの前髪を立てるためにこれは遅れたのかもしれませんね。
Comedy wrestling rules. There's people that hate comedy wrestling.
Give up.
She's got her right by the blue hair. And we got the ref that took a wave runner to the arena. CB ref. Beach ref. This is how you follow up that first match, folks.
トリプルHのベルトはですね、一応まだこの関わってないといいますかですね、そういう存在であります。北斗晶21世紀、まずは最初の外野マッチに出てまいりました。それは、それはあるのだ。さあ、せっかくあの試合始めにですね、ヒロチンやってましたからね、ひねってるっつーな、一つぐらいは出したいのかなという気もするんですけども、どのようにこの辺り続けていくのか。ブルサクラ、
What is this? Yeah, Chris Jericho going to DDT is very strange. I'm all for it though. That's rad. I actually pay for Wrestle Universe, which is why Noah gets when it comes to Buzzbin, I will go to Wrestle Universe first. Usually. Wow, that might be our thumbnail image right there for bullshit Nakano. Oh, she's seen enough bullshit.
しかしながらこの広田さくらの場合は三味線を引くという技を持っております。さあ、せっかく立てた前髪を完全に潰して、wow,
standing on her head.
北斗晶もちょっとこれはどうしたらいいのかといった感じだ。 まだまだまだ
She's Fonzie now. Give her a leather jacket, she's Fonzie. I just like Bull Nakano. And you're Akira Hokuto. I don't care about the Sea-Doo referee. I don't care about that. Look at that. Look at me come up with parody songs on the damn fly. I'm like Weird Scott. Uh-oh, she's got those nunchucks. No effect. No effect on those.
おっと、これはダイビングギロチンドロップの体勢か。しかし、相手に全くダメージを与えていない状況で。
She's on the top rope. She looks. She's telling her to get into position, I think. Oh! Knocked her off. Stomp. Oh, absolutely. I am a great freestyler. I am one of New York's best rappers. And if you know, you know. Oh my God! How are we watching two amazing matches back to back? Wrestling rules. Oh my God. Oh no. Wow. Yowza.
さあ、どうする?デイキューもああいう形でやったの初めて見ました。まあ、北斗に相当油断があったかな。さあ、この辺り、ヒロタは北斗のダメージはいかほどか。トップロープでホッカー、アキラ。さあ、体勢は万全だ。
It asked me if that chat was okay, if Murder German was okay.
なるほど。そのときよりは進歩しているほど、単純に証明いたしました、ヒロタクラ。4年もやってんですから、進歩してるけど嘘ですね。そうですね。ギブアップ、もうダメだから、帰れないから。さあ、ギブアップと言っておりますが、
セコンドの大将もこれはヒロタに行けと。さあ、これで終わりか。Oh, your winner. If it was any, you know. Is there any question on who is going to win? Akira Hokuto, folks. Right in the asshole. Ding, 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 ding. Now, if anyone wants to call in, now is one of the times to call in via my link tree. We'll get it going. I'm gonna change screens. Oh, I wish I knew what they were saying. It's probably hilarious.
あっさり決まりました。これは意外な展開が起きておりました。第1試合。
What the hell? That cop. Wow, she's getting big laughs.
Yoshiko,
Yes. All right. Back to this screen. If anybody has a tale to tell about weird, bad wrestling fans they've encountered, now is the time. Hit up that little QR code right there. That'll take you to the link tree that's got the damn Zoom link. Get in there and we'll chat it up. Yeah, dog it. We will do it. We will do it. But while I'm waiting for a caller, I will talk about this. I got this in the mail today. I got this from our friend Gotch Style Bong Rips. He put out a great zine, high quality, all color. Look at this. He's a figurehead. He's got a lot of figures, and so he puts them together. And this is just rad, man. So I got this. Follow him. Look, we got a big shot of Willie right there. Gotch Style Bong Rips on Instagram. A great follow. Pick yourself up a zine. Look at this zine, and I'll show you my favorite part in this zine. There's a little section all cool stuff online, and look at what is cool online. It's the damn Pro Wrestling Potluck. Look at that. Gotch Style Bong Rips. Hit them up. Get yourself a copy. It comes with a little figure. Look at this little figure. Look at this little figure. Now, do you know who this is? I didn't know who this is. I had to send Gotch Style Bong Rips a shameful message. I was ashamed to send them this message. I said, I got the zine, I got the minifig. Please tell my ignorant ass who this is. Who is this man? And so then he says, God bless. He says, honestly, I'm not too sure on his name myself. He's a K-1 fighter, though. And then he immediately came back and said, it's Alexei Ignashov. So next week, we're going to have some Alexei Ignashov on the show for my little man right here. There you go. Valhalla Combat Club. He didn't need me to tell him. Wowee. Where have you been all my life? All right. Is there anybody in the room? Is this the biggest failure in show history? No, it's not. Adam Suzanne is in the waiting room. Great. We got this waiting room. All right. All right. Let me switch screens. We're doing it. We're telling these tales. And I got one, too. All right. I'll be right back as I get everything.
Boom, boom.
Here we go. We're going to go first. First one I saw is Adam Suzanne. So we're going to hit up Adam Suzanne. Let me do it. Joining. Hopefully I got this all right. You know me, I usually have some kind of technical issue.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Adam Suzanne, how are you doing?
Howdy.
Can the people hear Adam Suzanne? I just need a thumbs up or something. If you're afraid to call, I'm just using your audio. I'm not putting video up there because you never know. Some weirdo might show up and show his butt or something, which would actually be great if some weirdo called up. But Adam Suzanne, how are you, my friend?
I'm doing well. I'm very honored and humbled to have been on your top 25. It made my day.
Number seven on the PWP 25.
I'd have put Masha above me, but I don't know.
Nah, she didn't contribute enough to the show. she was only in a buzz bend, a gimmick match, made a cameo, but you know, whatever. She didn't give enough. So do you have a story, a tale to tell about a wrestling fan you've witnessed?
And I went to the 96 Survivor Series.
Oh, yes.
And there was a guy next to me. I was a young Suzanimal. I was about 10 at the time. And a guy next to me, he had his, I believe what would be referred to as some sort of dirt sheet. It was, he kept to like, they'll never get it. Yeah. So there was a Survivor Series with a mystery partner, and this man kept informing me that it's gonna be Ahmed Johnson. It's gonna be Ahmed Johnson, and it was not Ahmed Johnson.
Who so, was it?
Well, might have been better to be Ahmed. It was Jimmy Snuka.
Oh, murderer! A murderer.
accused for
yes
for legit for legal potluck legal yeah. team accused.
Yeah, that's the last thing I need. So Jimmy Snuka instead of Ahmed. We would have all wanted Ahmed instead, especially in that year.
He was the man. He was, yeah. I didn't know what he was saying, but I thought it was awesome.
And he just had like a crazy style too. He did like power moves, and he was a little unhinged in his moves.
Yeah, Brian, that was the night the Rocky Maivia debuted with his weird
pineapple Rocky.
Yeah, with his fringe gear, like the paper, what's it called, the paper prey paper,
yeah,
like things.
Wow. Yeah, do you have another one?
This is one of those stories I've never told, and I could not believe, and it happened, but it did happen. So this was WrestleMania 35, and a guy, he's cosplaying as Hulk Hogan.
Oh, great.
Alrighty. So
strike
he's
one.
Cosplaying, he's got the brother, and he just, and this is, and that's only where it begins. And so he's doing his shtick for people. So people, and he points at somebody. The guy he points at is black, and he says, "I don't like you."
Oh no! Oh Jesus!
And he then realizes what he meant, because he then points at his hat, and he means, "I mean Red Sox fans." And then just runs away. And it was one of the most uncomfortable things I've ever.
Oh my god!
He
put on the costume and truly became
so
Hulkster.
He was a method actor, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
It was so.
Wow.
Everyone was just quiet for the next 2 hours. And didn't say anything, because it was, no one knew what how to respond to that.
Oh my god!
Because it was that uncomfortable, and I.
That's it. That's really wonderful. Yeah. God damn, thank you. That's exactly what we're looking for.
I feel vindicated.
Yeah. All right, Adam, thank you so much.
Absolutely. Long live the wrestle, pals.
Yes. All right, let's go to Dr. Liam next. Let me get my little thing over here. Dr. Liam joining now. All right, connecting to audio. Dr. Liam? How
Mr. Green?
Are you?
Mr.
Yes.
Green,
yes.
How are you, my friend?
I'm great. Any better, I couldn't stand it.
So you want to hear about crazy fans, huh?
Yes, please.
So this was 1999. WF The Music Volume 4 was just released. And I bought it at Virgin Megastore. And they were like, hey, here's a pass. There's going to be a CD signing. I was like, oh, cool. Who's it going to be? Chris Jericho and the New Age Outlaws.
Wow.
So I'm online waiting to get my CD signed. And they kept telling us repeatedly, no pictures, in no uncertain terms. Do not take any photography. Do not take any pictures of any of the wrestlers, blah, blah, blah. So I had a guy, I was 21 at the time. The guy ahead of me was probably the age I am now, my mid-40s, and he kept bugging me the whole time. Bro, when I get up there, you got to take my picture with Jericho. You got to take my picture with Jericho. I said, I'm not doing that, man. They said they're going to toss somebody out if they got... Like, why am I on this line to to get tossed out to help you, a stranger, snap an awkward photo?
A photo that no one wants.
Yeah, exactly. I think Jericho had debuted around that time for WWF.
Okay, yeah.
But he was like, but the dude was the whole time, and we waited for probably 20, 30 minutes to get the CD signed. And I kept telling him, nah, man, nah, I'm not doing it. And he goes, oh, but it would mean so much. Like, when we were almost there, he was in near tears.
Wow, this guy really loved Jericho in 1999. He hadn't even become...
In 1999.
The year of Prince.
The other story I have is not... It's only quasi-wrestling related. It's a quick one. I met Sergeant Slaughter in, I think it was 2000.
Oh.
At like one of these small comic book conventions that they used to have in New York City. And if you remember from the 90s in comic books, the big things was like Lady Death, Vampirella, these
the
women
bad
with
girl
very
phase,
bad...
the bad girl phase of comics.
Yeah. So at these conventions, they would have women dressed up as those characters.
Oh, the booth babes.
Yeah. And there was so
I'm right there for this.
I'm online waiting to see Slaughter, and there's a lady dressed up as one of those characters. At next to a booth, and there's a guy, just I think he was Asian, just snapping pictures at her. And she goes, hey, you know, if you want to take my picture, you got to give me money, you know, this is my job.
Yeah.
And in perfect English, he goes, no English, and just kept taking pictures of
her. Wow. That's funny. I've actually used that before on one of those like street canvassers, one of those Greenpeace people or whatever, with the clipboards.
I've done that too.
I've said straight up, I've looked them right in the eye and said, I don't speak English.
I've done that to them. One of them one time was like, I'll walk with you to work. I said, no.
You better not.
Some bodily harm may come your way if you do that.
Yeah. Oh, man. That's great. Thank you, Dr. Liam.
Thank you for having me, Scott.
No problem. We're going to keep it moving. We got one more, and then we'll get back to action. We got Sartori in the house. Thank you, Dr. Liam.
Thank you.
All right, getting Sartori in here. This is going great. I was worried that no one was going to call and I was going to be humiliated. Right. Sartori in the house. John All and right. Ann's Wrestling Podcast on
you know
YouTube.
It.
The latest one you guys are talking about, the Joshi show you went to.
Oh, yeah. I went to Sukibon or Skabon.
I think it's Sukibon, but I have no idea.
The ring announcer said Skabon, and then I was like, you know, it is Shinsuke Nakamura.
Yeah.
Right? You know, I do. You do the ske, so I feel like that's what it is. But I think it's fine to say Sukibon. Actually, this isn't one I was going to talk about, but at that show, speaking of bad wrestling fans, there was like a family there that seemed like they got in for free to be like seat fillers or something, even though it was like a totally packed show. Because this one little kid, like, they didn't seem like wrestling fans, and this one little kid that was with them was just piercingly screaming the entire time. Like, he was screaming at the matches, like, fight! Fight! And he was just screaming, and it was just, people were leaving after a while, and it was like a 90-minute show. And
that's a perfect show length.
It was great, especially because it was the day after Dynamite, so it was like, very long show and then a tiny little show, and it was great. Yeah. And then that kid, at one point, he was screaming fight while a match was happening, and his mom like tapped him on the shoulder and was like, they are fighting right now, they're fighting.
You little idiot.
Yeah. So that happened. That was recent. I feel like I have to talk about this. You were there for, and so was Cool
Dude
Food.
I was waiting for who was going to bring this up.
And so there was... This is my birthday, and we went to a fun... It was Warriors of Wrestling.
Warriors of Wrestling in South Brooklyn.
Yeah, it was in a church, a big old cross on the wall, and it was... we were there, and I don't even remember what started this. We kind of were like standing in the back because there weren't a lot of seats open, and there was just... I don't even remember what instigated this, but this lady was just... It was this older woman... who was there seemingly by herself, but seemed to know everyone. Like, I think she was a regular. And she was wearing a baseball cap that said Salty on it. and she just started... She was just yelling. And she didn't really seem like she was that dialed into what was going on. She just started yelling it.
She was arguing with someone seated around her when we were there.
She was arguing with somebody who was then kind of just, like, laughing at her. It was another older woman who seemed to like kind of know her and know her deal and was just like taking it in stride. But she was yelling like almost racist things at this person. It was not comfortable. It was very weird. And then we kind of started telling her to, I think Owen started kind of telling her to like stop.
Pull out. Yeah. No, Owen was like a perfect gentleman. He was like, look, there's no reason to yell. And then once she was like yelling at him, then he started having fun with her.
Yeah, and it was a very and so she had this habit that's Salty, and then she started yelling at us, and then like kind of like flicking her fingers at mostly at Owen.
Yes,
because he was the one standing up to her for the most part, and it was kind of like a Danhausen curse, which he called out, and she was doing all this while pounding a Snickers bar. She had a Snickers open, and she was just chomping away on this thing and doing just cursing him out. I can't remember what she was saying to him, but it was insane. And she was like drooling with the Snickers bar.
It was wild. This was an insane woman who, like you were saying, they had to have known her. She was like had to be a regular there, but she was just she was wound up, and she was bouncing around yelling at people. And once she had a target at our friend Owen Straw, he was there, and she just could not get over that he was telling her to calm down.
Yeah, and then the cops came and made her leave.
They took her out.
Yeah, and she was like very. She was like, "No, please let me stay." It was actually like really sad.
It was. But, and she was called Salty Snickers. That's how we refer
Salty
to her
Snickers
when we tell this story.
Exactly.
It felt to me like it was the most like indie show that I've been to up here. Like, I'm from Louisiana, so I've seen like some real dirtball indies, and all the stuff I go to up here is like dope, you know, good wrestlers and good shit.
It's like GCW.
Yeah, and like smart fans and stuff. This was like a straight up mutant that you know, wrestling needs mutants to fuel the machine, and she was a mutant.
She was. She really, truly was. And then another quick one that I have is I went to SummerSlam in 2018. I think it was the last Barclays Center one. And I went with my buddy from work, and there was, I mean, this was like, you know, packed Barclays Center, and it was like, you know, everybody's going nuts, right? And there's just a guy sitting behind us who was on what must have been like a 45-minute phone call about like his plumbing business. And it was like, there was some drama happening, but he was like very casually sitting there just on this phone call the whole time. And he was just like a very New York guy. He's like, you know, I mean, look, you know, you said you called somebody, you said what you said, you know, and you shouldn't have done that, you know, and now I got to deal with it, you know, and it's, you know, it's, you're going to cost me a lot of money. And it just went on. And I'm like, what could that possibly have sounded like on the other end?
Yeah.
The roaring of the crowd.
Probably like hearing Nakamura's music in the background or something like that while he's conducting business.
Yeah, it was Becky Lynch's big heel turn. That was where the whole man thing started. I think it was actually like around that match. Yeah, a historic show.
He wasn't even dialed in. He was doing business, a businessman.
No, you know. Yeah, and then this one time I went to WrestleMania 35 and I cosplayed as Hulk Hogan. And I did what I thought was a very funny joke. Okay. It apparently made people very uncomfortable. You know what? That's it. That's all I got.
All right. Well, thank you.
All right. Thank you. Great show.
Thank you. All right. Let's get back to the action. Might do some more calls later if anybody's got more stories. I got mine. I still need to tell, but we'll get back to it. All right. Thank you. Oh, whoop. That's not what I need to do. I need to turn this off. Let me take my little Zoom meeting thing and put that right there, and then that, we press that, and then we go to this, and we go back over here, and we press. I have no idea what these commercials are about. Whoa. Is that a cheese puff? It is. Anime lines. Oh yeah, we're going over our time today, folks. I hope that's okay. We're going way the fuck over our time. All right. Now, this was sent in by Dr. Liam, who we heard not too long ago. And I got a little background on this. Let me bring it up. There's Julia, number two. Julia's number two in the PWP 25, as we all remember. So this is from a show that's translated Monstrous Battlefield, where sumo wrestlers compete with physical entertainers in a series of challenges. And this sumo's name is Wakataka Kage, who's a famous sumo, Wakataka Kage. A fun name to say, Wakataka Kage. Going head to head with Julia, and look who the referee is. By God, it's Jushin Thunder Liger. Now that doesn't seem fair. Waka Taka Kage wins. All right. Now, this was sent in by Sartori. John Sartori of John and Ann's Wrestling Podcast sent this in a while ago. Brian Danielson versus a young Zack Sabre Jr. looking like he's in the Strokes or something.
Come on, Zack! Screw you, Kevin! Sir!
What's that?
What's that?
It's not worthy.
Yeah! What's that?
Wow. Starting off the technical wrestling, which you should not be surprised. Whoa. Hand to the face of young Zack Sabre Jr. Got the wrist. Now tying up the arm of Danielson. Yeah, referee, beautiful hair on the referee. Oh my God. Danielson looks like he's beating up his teenage son. Look at this. Zach doing his favorite thing, his little...
Thank you. I am the best in the world.
Oh, and now he's doing it. Getting that extra pressure, but look at Zach, he's bridging up too. I would be shocked if this crowd wasn't drunk. I can hear everyone in my headphones, and I can just smell the whiskey breath. Andrew Heelan. The crowd firmly behind young, skinny Zack Sabre Jr. Finally see his face. Get that hair out of your face, Zack Sabre Jr. Wow, this is a small crowd, and they are arguing with each other Danielson had to tell that guy to stop swearing because there's children there.
Kick him, Zach. Come on. Kick him in the ass.
Kick him.
Break his ribs, Zach. Oh.
Now, this is ripped from the headlines. That's what we're going to call this. We'll say this is ripped from the headlines. We got the big-time rematch at Wrestle Dream Sunday. The dream match. This is merely a daydream they once had. Headlock. Take Zach. Zach with the head scissors. They're both back up. This would probably be a great show to have a pint and yell at the wrestlers. Yeah, this is like, this is the kind of match Todd Barry should be the referee for.
You have nothing, man. You've got to fall. Fuck you. Come on, Zach.
Come on,
Saber.
Come on, Zach. Beat him with jet lag. Come up,
Zach. Ooh.
Come on, Zach.
Oh, Zach with the kicks, getting Danielson in the corner. Can you imagine? This is a great crowd for stand-up. Although they would be heckling. You would have to really do some crowd control, shut down the loud one. Oh, Zach got him, but Danielson found a way out. Zach back to work on that arm. Danielson finds a way out. Takedown on Zach. Zach holding his head, but doesn't matter because Danielson's going after that ankle. It's like Bryan Danielson has shown up to a teenage wrestling federation. Look at this crowd. They got nice little tables and shit. Is this like an ambush show? Were those people just there to eat and then a wrestling show happened? Danielson holding that arm. Will we see that on Sunday? He's going in there with a damaged arm. Look at these fans. You want to talk about mutants?
Seven. Eight.
Oh, why did you shake Bryan Danielson's hand? Uppercut! Young Zach learned an important lesson. Face first into the turnbuckle now. Oh, getting the heck kicked out of him. Uh-oh, surfboard. Surfboard coming. He's getting the feet. Crowd knows what's coming. They don't want to see their little boy, Zach. Ooh, got him by the nose. That nasty motherfucker. I love how Brian Danielson is like a great technical wrestler, but he's also goofy, but then he's fucking mean. I think my favorite thing that I found out recently is that there is no Zack Sabre Sr. There is no Zack Sabre Sr. He just made that up. He made himself a junior. Isn't that weird? Made himself a junior. Ooh, look at that. Got the head, still controlling those legs. And that's why the Suzanimal is on the booking committee. Once we start Potluck Wrestling Federation, Suzanimal is on the booking committee. Choking him with his own arms. That's a pro move. Dragging that little British shit to the center of the ring. Ref got a fresh haircut for this one. Choking Danielson with a hip arm. Look at this. Oh, flips him over. A kick to the back, and he's so skinny he could feel it in the front. Dos.
Zach, huh?
Stepping on the head. They love Zack Sabre Jr. here at the Sabre family reunion. I keep waiting for the curtain to open and the Rockafire explosion to start playing. The Rockafire explosion starts playing Final Countdown. Earlier on a call, Dr. Liam mentioned the Virgin Megastore. I used to work at the Virgin Megastore at the early 2000s, and I worked with guys who looked like Zack Sabre Jr. and the long-haired referee. That is what my coworkers looked like at the Virgin Megastore. Punches in the corner, Zack's covering up, dropping down. Slumping down in the corner. Yeah, I really didn't know what to expect from this match. This is very young Zack Sabre Jr. He's not that long into the biz at this point. think it is 2008. I think Virgin Megastores are mostly gone. I worked in record stores and video stores, so I got a lot in common with a fucking coal miner. I might as well have worked in a buggy whip factory. I got no skills now. Ooh, Zach doing a roll into a kick. Table service. Flying out and low! Right at the feet of the patrons who are just trying to have some fish and chips and a pint, a warm pint of lager. Yeah. I got stories to tell from my Virgin Megastore days. I'm not going to even start. I'll find an excuse to tell those stories another day. Oh! Look at this! Trading pinfall attempts. Yeah, I worked in a local video store in the New Orleans area, and one of my favorite jobs. It's a great job for a stoned person who doesn't like people, but gets to deal with them and then make fun of them with coworkers. Great job. I like it. I like it. I like it. I'm adding it to the list. I have a list of gimmick shows. And I have three that are coming up. Danielson's fired up now. He was going easy on this little prick. Two! Fan stock. That was it. So did Zack Sabre Jr.
Attention, Owen Straw.
Come on, Sarge. Not now. Not now, Sarge. Oh, forearms. Danielson. Whoa. Backflip over ZSJ. Stop that momentum with a kick. Look at this. Up to the suplex bridge. Up from them toes. Two. Count. Zach grabs that arm. Armbar City. That child ref, did that child ref screw up like Rick Knox? The worst referee. I saw
Brian Danielson.
Wow, that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am one of the first to acknowledge that Bryan Danielson is one of the best in the world. The referee has just turned to me and told me he made a mistake. There's no way that he made a mistake in that count. I clearly saw a 1, 2, 3.
What the hell?
With a vast crowd of stupidity, that was definitely a 3 count. Do you agree or disagree?
I thought that was a 3 count.
With the greatest of respect.
This guy, this dipshit in the vest is doing a pet peeve of mine. He's holding the microphone like this. Hold it down here.
It's 5 more minutes. Now I'm going to say everyone that was a 2 count.
Strip club manager authority figure.
But I'm sure being the man that you are, you would like to prove that it was 3.
Hey, I'm an authority figure for American Coliseum Wrestling up in Rockland County, New York. I'll be up there next month.
The only person in this crowd that matters.
That little kid.
And that's the young lady with the Bryan Danielson t-shirt.
Oh. There's a woman there? There's a woman in that wrestling crowd?
Do you want
crowd?
5 more minutes? Or do you want that to be the end of it?
Oh, it's a drink. She was brought there.
Get in here, and we'll go another half hour if we have to.
Wow. Zach able to get a breather. He's ready for these 5 more minutes. Oh, for the love of Christ. Yeah, no Rick Knox, please. No Rick Knox on Sunday. Tony Khan doesn't watch this show live. He watches it on the weekend. Tony Khan, suspend Rick Knox and free Jack Perry. I'm ready for Jack Perry to come back. I'm ready to hear the glass break, cult of personality, and Jack Perry to come out, baby. Ooh, Zach trying to slap the face of Danielson with the little power that he has, laid on a heap in the center of the ring.
Come on, Zach!
Come on! Yeah!
Come on, Zach!
Come on, Zach!
Come on, Zach!
Here's the roof, Zach!
Are his feet gonna touch the ceiling? Okay, it is. Superplex. Going for a pin, but Saber! Whoop! The Saber steals one! steals one. Zack Sabre Jr. kind of looks like one of Meadow Soprano's boyfriends from, I think, season 2 of Sopranos, which I will be getting to soon on my Sopranos rewatch. Hey, don't hurt that little boy referee. You're 2 out of 3. That's how bad the officiating is. Oh, this blows. Oi, cut. Five more falls. Five more falls is a great chant. I don't want to see it, but that's a great chant.
Oi.
Oi. DDT! That's not how you hold a microphone, you dipshit! The fans chant the steps. It's so perfect. Section and tables and drinks. We are going over tonight, folks. This is going to be... Last week's was the longest episode. I don't think it's going to go as long as last week, but we'll see. Almost there to that point. Uh-oh. Stepping on the chin. Kick to the face. I don't know. I don't know if I have a harder time starting on time or finishing on time. big time. Belly to back. Superplex. Zach finds a way to... Wow. And that is that. Brian Danielson wins this impromptu 2 out of 3 falls match.
You know, I came in here hating all these retards, right?
Hey now.
But Zach, you proved tonight you're a hell of a wrestler. So stand up, shake my hand.
Brian.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for a guy who fought his heart out tonight, Zach Sabre Jr.
Wow. I need to find out how to do that. That's going to be the next step of the potluck. Next potluck, I'm going to be like, hey, welcome to the potluck.
Ladies and gentlemen, Zach Sabre Jr.
All right. Wow. Smooth like butter, like a criminal undercover. Oh, I need to. Pop like trouble breaking into your heart like that. Cool shit. Where's the Frito twist? Is it playing? Is the Frito twist playing? Okay. This music is actually BTS, and that's one of the things I'm scared of. K-pop will kill me, man. They'll stop my account dead.
I'm here to say you're not swinging until you twist your troubles away. You do it like this, the Frito twist.
You want the blues to blow, you just can't stay. Attraction, introducing team number one.
All right.
From La Follette, Tennessee, he weighs 225 pounds, Greg Evans.
Greg Evans in the house.
From Little Beach, South Carolina, weighing 220 pounds, dude. Lee Scott.
Lee Scott. Now, this was sent in by Andrew Heelan.
First from the Double Cross Ranch in Canyon, Texas. He weighs 247 pounds. Hurry!
Defense Mechanism Records. Check out Andrew Heelan on YouTube, Defense Mechanism Records. He's got a lot of wrestling matches, VHS that he has converted. And also a lot of live shows, live songs from MTV and other things.
Of the team that you will see in the Thunderdome match in a couple of weeks.
The great Muda and Terry Funk. And Sting, that's a goddamn wrestle dream.
And Terry Funk.
Well, and I tell you, we're wondering who Flair and Sting were going to get that might be as sadistic as Hart for that third man in that corner. And I tell you, I was sort of surprised when they came up with Ole Anderson, but I think he was a great one to come up with, because if anybody can match Hart and stand there and refuse to let his man quit, it's going to be Ole Anderson.
Ole Anderson, as he mentioned, you've got the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, and that's the kind of attitude that he's got. Rough and tough, and that's the way he always was. And it was a masterful choice by Ric Flair and Sting for there, as
Lance Russell
calls them, Bob. He calls them, those guys outside the ring, not second, He calls them terminators. They have the ability to terminate the match right then and there.
And they're the only ones that can do it. And by the way, fans, if you can't be with us in Philadelphia on the 28th, you want to make your plans right now. Call your cable company now. Be sure you see it. Halloween Havoc is something that you really don't want to miss.
Right now, Funk is fired into the ring rope. And coming off is Greg Evans. He is nailed hard by Funk out of the ring and down on the floor. And this is where it really gets dangerous.
Lance, we're talking about calling your cable company. And also, you're going to be right there in Philadelphia. Something that I love to hear. And all the fans across the country can call you on the 900 number. It's going to be action live right on the 900 number, right?
Yes, sir. We will be right there
in
Philadelphia.
Roll up.
Be there. Don't have their cable operator set up. They can call us on the 1-900-909-9900, and they'll hear every minute that they care to right on the 900. Look at Funk drive that elbow. Lee Scott.
Great mood as a hero,
we've said
actually.
It before, and bears repeating.
The end. A Terry Funk pile driver on that goofy dude.
And Sting. Here comes Muda. Match, Bob.
Well, there's no doubt.
Clean up crew.
I'm sure all our wrestling fans know. He felt the power of that pile driver.
Backbreaker now. The most mind-blowing move.
Big backflip off the ropes. 1, 2, 3.
Muda's moonsault looks like a weapon. It looks offensive. Most people's moonsaults look like flippy trash. That looks like it hurts somebody.
Absolutely right on top of it.
Have a good squash.
We've got the Road Warriors.
Always send in squashes. We need them on this show. This is not a greatest hit show. We do all kinds of stuff. I love a squash.
Poderoso padre, dime cómo haces tú para ser el maestro de maestros del PUBG Mobile. Yo me esfuerzo para campear como un pro, pero no lo consigo. Si del PUBG Mobile quieres ser un crack, mis consejos debes escuchar. Para ganar en equipo, debes trabajar. Ayuda a los caídos. Comparte tu munición y aplica estrategia. No todo en la vida es el sniper. A veces tienes que acercarte y ensuciarte las manos para alcanzar la victoria. Pero si en crack te quieres convertir, las skins más facheras debes conseguir, porque ganar no es nada sin estilo para presumir.
Oh my God, look at all these... all these thumbnails! We're gonna...
Soy el número
uno. Oh my God.
Ahí les va. Y recuerda que tras la victoria alcanzada, con un baile épico debes celebrar. Como el KEMONITO dance que te voy a mostrar.
I'm not smart enough to figure it out.
Siguiendo mis consejos, lejos llegarás.
KEMONITO with the blue afro wig. Now I've seen it all.
We got, I think, one more match, but a couple of things before that. KEMONITO had a press conference on Monday where he accused CMLL of all kinds of things, and now they're not getting along. KEMONITO is trying to do his own thing now. He wanted to retire, they wouldn't let him, and now they're trying to come up with all these fake KEMONITOs. We are on Team KEMONITO here. KEMONITO! Free KEMONITO! And now I would like to talk to Tony Khan. Tony Khan, I know you watch this show, and I just want to tell you, now is the time. Bring in KEMONITO. You no longer have to worry about AAA, CMLL nonsense. Bring in KEMONITO. Give him the payday he deserves, that the wrestling world knows that he deserves. Bring in KEMONITO. Put him with the best friends. Right? Or put him with Hulk. Put him... Just keep him away from Matt freaking Hardy. That's it. But bring in KEMONITO. There is a place for KEMONITO. And I am throwing out a prediction right now. Wrestle Dream. The end of an era for AEW and the beginning of a new era. And that new era will be General Manager KEMONITO. Make it happen, TK. So that's what I wanted to say about that. And real quick, I'm going to tell my little wrestling crowd story. I was at the Dynamite Rampage at Arthur Ashe last week. It was a hell of a time, a fun show, a long show, but not as long as the previous years, I think, by a few minutes. But I had dummies behind me, and I overheard this quote from a dummy behind me. It was after a pile driver had been done in the match, and we saw the replay of the pile driver, and the guy was like, "Oh yeah, you can see that his head don't even hit. His head don't even hit. That's not a good pile driver. Owen Hart versus Stone Cold. That's the best pile driver I ever seen in my life." That's what this man said. Owen Hart versus Stone Cold. That's the best pile driver I've seen in my life. That almost ended his career. That's like being like, "Oh yeah, the stunts on Mission Impossible, those are great. But that's not, my favorite stunts are from Twilight Zone the movie." Someone died. One more. It's like being like, "Boy, I love space travel, but it's not dangerous enough. My favorite shuttle was the Challenger." God damn, these wrestling fans. He had no idea what he was saying. He didn't even, he was clueless. But boy, oh boy, I immediately wrote that down. I heard it. I think I looked right at Owen and brought out my little phone and wrote it down. Look at this. I wrote it down. So that inspired this. And one more crowd story from my youth. I went to a bad indie wrestling show in Chalmette, Louisiana, which is like the part of everyone from the New Orleans surrounding area. They can all look down their nose at Chalmette. It's the worst of the worst. And so I went to an indie show in Chalmette, Louisiana, and about halfway through the show, someone's making their entrance, and a drunk fan, I'm just going to guess he was drunk, took a swing at a wrestler. And it was one of those old school things where everyone ran out, all the boys ran out of the locker room. They started beating the shit out of fans. There was like a little riot. All the chairs were pushed away, and they ended the show. That was the end of the show. And that was it. It was just everybody left. And then Clint, my buddy Clint, who's sometimes in this chat, who made our current logo that I love so much, Clint was just like, jumped in the ring, started running the ropes. And that was my biggest regret. For many years, I was too afraid to jump the barricade at this riot and run the ropes. And Clint did it. So that's my story. Mox did not get concussed on those pile drivers. He got concussed when Phoenix jumped on his head. Those pile drivers were fine. It was just that they had to do them twice because Rick Knotts is the worst referee on television by far. All right, we got a couple more things. We're going over. Oh, good Lord. All right. Uh-oh, it's the FMW. It's the FMW alarm. Oh, my God. Mahalo Combat Club, thank you for gifting subs. Now, this was sent in by Cool Dude Food himself. I think this is a fraudulent KEMONITO versus perhaps a fraudulent Alushe. I mean, at this point, is there a legitimate Alushe? I don't know. This is not our main event. I was wrong. There's another match. Now, if you don't know, the character on the left is what KEMONITO was doing until like 2005 or something. Alushe, who was a fake Ewok. And then he got that taken from him, and he went and became KEMONITO. And that's Shocker Sito right there. This is a three-way between Shocker Sito, I do not think that's the real KEMONITO, and Alushe. Is that the real Alushe? Of course not. The real Alushe is KEMONITO. We have watched some Alushe on this show, and it's the fake one. We watched the beatboxing Michael Jackson impersonator. Rubbing the S. That's it. That's all we got from that. What is this? What the crap?
He's Nick Laser. He'll fight till his last breath. This is Karate Goes to Dojo of Death. Dojo, let's go. Karate Goes. Dojo, let's go. Karate
there you go. John hitting it. That's called relaxing.
Dojo, let's go. Karate Goes. Dojo, let's go. Karate Goes. Yeah! He's Nick Laser.
I did too. I'm going 30 seconds over for this. I'm going over for our main event.
Strong enough. I learned some new moves. Some Taekwondo. Now let's go.
Is this a movie?
Oye, Rush.
Pasó, ¿qué pasó?
Oye, quiero que me digas qué le quieres decir a ese negro. Pasas el primero de agosto en el juicio final.
Tú también estás preguntando qué no has visto también tú, qué bonito, ¿sí? Que...
Pero ya que están las cámaras aquí, negro, te voy a retirar, como te lo he dicho. Las palabras se las lleva el viento y los hechos, de esos hechos, me voy a encargar yo. Recuerda que yo te voy a retirar, perro. Y tú, no me preguntes ni madre.
¡Qué bonito! ¡Es lo bonito!
All right, hold up.
In the future, everything will be simple. With just a look and a thought, anything can be yours. Looking further. Deeper. Longer. Into the buzz.
All right. You might have seen clips of this, and now we're going to watch it. The Bullet Train match. We are joining 10 minutes in progress because there's only one competitor so far. Senshiro Takagi has already entered the Bullet Train. And the Bullet Train is stopping right now. So yeah, I cut out the beginning of this for time, but it's basically 30 minutes, so we're going over. Uh-oh, I hear music! I hear music on this train! Let me turn it up just to Frog's hair.
いいですね。あの、新幹線って発車する時の音楽とかあるじゃないですか。はい。どちらの人もいませんとか。はい。風になるも悪くないです。結構なんか目が覚めちゃいますね。はい。So
this isn't on Wrestle Universe yet. I got this this fell off the back of a truck. もしかすると、ブギミノルが乗り遅れてるのではないかと。
緊張感です。
Yeah, I wasn't. I didn't know that he's the man at DDT. I'm ignorant.
I haven't
watched any of this, so I really don't know what to expect besides like the two clips that I've seen. The train is moving again. Here comes the part everybody loves. I'm gonna turn it up. All the passengers are ready. The door opens. It's Minoru Suzuki. He's on the bullet train. I will use my pull to make that happen. Why not just do a match on the J train? Valhalla Combat Club, you're right. This is the second week in a row that Minoru Suzuki is main eventing the potluck. Somebody's looking for a spot on the PWP 25 next year. I was the only person on the bus today on my way home for this show. It was beautiful. I cut a little promo on the bus, put it in my Instagram stories. Bus driver probably thought I was insane. And I literally had him drop me off right in front of my apartment. It was beautiful. Referee.
確かに新幹線車内にですね、凶器とか危険なものは持ち込めませんからね。そうですね。はい。He's
getting laughs.
怒りました。お客様ですよ。知らねえよそんなもん。鈴木みのる選手は DDT の選手ではないので、外敵なので知ったこっちゃないという態度です。
The bell has been rung and this match is underway. The train is going.
まずは車掌コール。
なんというタイミングで車掌さんが。さあ、この非常に限定されたフィールドでの。Suzuki is definitely the scariest to do comedy wrestling, but not the scariest to do comedy. There's a lot of scary criminals that do stand-up comedy.
そういう系が多いので、意外と新幹線プロレス行ける。
気がしてるんですよ。
確かにポップチョップとか、
はい、
いけますね。
はい、おやすみエクスプレスもできます、ね、
できますね。
This is not a quiet car, I'll say that。
まずはおやすみエクスプレスの場合どうやって相手を寝転がらせるかっていうのはありますよ
ね。お客さんに踏んづけてもらうとか。
さすがラクさんです。さあ、おお鈴木みのるに対して、あ、タックルを狙いましたが、スタンディングのアームロック。
If you are watching this and you're not subscribed, please give me a little follow on here or subscription, whatever it takes. Follow me. We do this every Thursday night. It's a different show every week. Oh, and I there was something I wanted to talk about too. I'll do it after this, I guess.
下手すると背もたれがバキッといく可能性もあるんで。
そうですよね、
はい、これは気をつけなければいけません。あとですね、この画面を見れば分かるように、あの新幹線ってすごくあのサスペンションがいいんですよね。
I know in New York they do subway wrestling. I've seen the clips. Macho Man, who frequents our chat, is involved. If I was on the train and subway wrestling broke out, I would be angry. Because it means I would be late to work or late going home. And I'd like to go home. I love going home.
Whoa.セカンドロープが喋りました。なるほど、まあ、いわゆるプロレスにはロープブレイク、何か関節技とかを仕掛けられた場合ロープをつかむとね、エスケープになりますけども、
DDT rules。
このお客様が座っているシートが、まあ、ロープ代わりにエスケープゾーンということになるんでしょう。
Train Ride from Hell might be the title。
まさに電車道。
I haven't been writing a lot down。
すっぱりです。だが聞きません。おお、電車道なんです。ああ、やっぱ言ってますね。普段こんな技やってませんからね。
There's a lot to see in this match。
月焼き場の相撲殺法は全く鈴木みのりには聞きません。
Chops are having no effect on Suzuki。 おお、
すごい音しましたよ今。
The sound of that forearm。
私あの新幹線結構乗ってますけど、あんな音したことないですからね。
Expertly delivered。
さすがです。百戦錬磨の鈴木みのる、たとえフィールドが新幹線であっても生き生きと戦っています。
So he's a weirdo, but he's not a rapist who covers for murderers and kills people with his practices. Referee letting Suzuki hear it.
全然言うことを聞いてくれません。
The chairs look comfortable. It really is just. We don't have it so good here in the United States.
によってはですね、途中の駅で停車してお前ら全員降りろと。
If we had a train like this, it would only be for the 45 richest Americans and their sex slaves. Shooing the cameraman away. Referee ducking behind. There's so much leg room, a referee can get in there and hide. Whoa, forward roll in the aisle.
新幹線のスピードと自身のパンチのスピードを合わせて400キロぐらいある。
お、
必殺パンチです。
おそらく
プロレス界、いや格闘技界最速のパンチが今高木三四郎を襲いました。スケット、ちょっと待ってください。スケット
どうですか。 The music hits. Some of the fans recognize.
DDT プロ
レス Takeshi Masada, I don't know him, but these fans do DDT.
確かこれ、
Masada 選手の DDT 名古屋大会があるんで、Minoru Suzuki, is this allowed?
名古屋に向かってるという情報だったんですが、乗ってたんですね。
乗ってたんですね。
Man, I would eat my dinner off that floor. I would eat soup off that floor. Suzuki looks pissed.
普通に切ってくださいよ。
These strikes having no effect on him.
スケットって出てきたことは高木三四郎が呼んだってことですからね。
2-on-1, this train needs to hurry up. Get to the next station.
さあどうやらこの新幹線プロレスのルール助っ人が許されていた模様です。
危ないことすんだよ。
2対1の状況で有利に戦いをする。
This is a violent man spreading.
ゴールに入ったがカウント2です。
Takagi Masada trying to double team Minoru Suzuki. Referee, what did he get from the ref? He's getting his phone. Suzuki making a call. Suzuki phone home. Who did he call? He called Kevin Nash. Tell Kevin Nash to stick him. Hey, it's Hikaru Sato. He's dressed to impress. Hikaru Sato might be winning best dress tonight. Violent man spreading. Putting it on the title list.
ジョーラーですけど、いいんですかね。あの上半身服を着てないで。
これはどうなるんですかね。やっぱ怒られますよね。新幹線はね、あの車掌さんとか、いわゆるその。カーゴのね、人とか、それ以外にもちゃんと警備の人が乗ってますからね。新幹線
プロレスになってれば職質
ですよね。職質です
よね。
さあカオスになってまいりました。当初のアナウンスだと完全に高木三四郎対鈴木みのりのシングルマッチという発表だったんですが、助っ人が現れてなんとこの狭い通路にプロレスラーが4人もいます。
Suzuki
大変だ。
Reaching Reaching for a bag. Oh, he's got an umbrella.
傘ですよ。
Now you can't open the umbrella inside. That's a horrible luck.
持ち込みは確かに
制限はできないのに。 Don't do it. No. Look at this image of this maniac.
初めて見ました。
Yeah, different. It's lucky to wear a turtleneck with no sleeves or back.
新幹線プロレスでなければですね、事件ですね。
事件です
ね。はい、これはね。ああ、なぜかカプセル怪獣にも勢い余って手を出してしまった鈴木みのるです。さあ。カプセル怪獣と助っ人同士が戦っている間、
Now these two, are they gonna just go away now? Takagi's got that umbrella now. He had it in his mouth. Umbrella to the back. Now he's choking Minoru Suzuki with that umbrella. That's a good looking umbrella. I will covet that umbrella.I had my umbrella stolen this week from Trader Joe's. My umbrella was stolen and I had to walk back to work in the rain. Whoever stole my umbrella, I hope you're dry. I hope you're dry forever. Whoa! Armbar on the beautiful floor of this bullet train. Grabbing this woman. I think there's a separate car for that. We got this dude, the best dressed, Sato. My little buddy is watching on.
いや、私もいろんなプロレスを実況してまいりましたが、すごいですね。 これはすごいですよ。
カオスですね、
はい、考えても普通やらないですよ、
うん、
よくこれ JR 東海が許しましたよね。
本当ですよね。JR さん結構
お
お硬いイメージあるんですけど、
でもこうやって懐の深いところをこの新幹線プロレスで見せてくれますし、まああと、まあ、こうやって最近この新幹線を、まあ、車両貸し切りでいろいろご利用できますよっていうね、はい、サービスが開始されて、うんまあ、その一環なんですけども、まさかこうやっていの一番に利用してるのがプロレスとは思わなかったですよね。
普通お誕生日会とかそういうのに使えますよ、
ね、そうですね、うん、あとはなんかアイドルの
そうです、ね、
イベントとか、
うんうん、
はい、プロレスとは。でも楽選手もこの新幹線プロレスが発表された時は、
はい、
選手として出たかったでしょう。
出たかったです、ね、
ヘッドバット to Sato
直接お願いしたんですけど、
はい、
やっぱり登場の試合が被ってたので。
そうだ、この日はですね、2023年9月18日、同じ名古屋の国際会議場ですね。昼間に東京女子プロレスの
大会がありまして、はい、まさに
そこに楽選手は今行ってい
て、はい、試合
をするかしないかの段階ですよね。
まさに、
はい、佐藤、fingers in the nose。
始発の新幹線だったら出てたかもしれないですね。
一人で
ここ揺れるはずなのに、このトンネル揺れるのに、なんてなんてなんてなんて、どうしてどうしてどうしてどうして、
再び
レフェリ
ー、お、なんだ、ああブレイクを
要請しています。 Look at this, almost mirror images here.
スケットがカプセル怪獣とスケットによ
ってレフェリーがなかなかチェックに入れません。 Yeah, they were doing mime earlier. Is there anything they can't do?
ロープロープとアピールしていますが、あー怒られた、
ギブアップギブアップらしいぞ、
あーとどめを刺しに行きます。この対戦は鈴木みのるの必殺技ゴッチ式、おーそれを
おーバックバディドロップ、
あーブラブラブラ、
おー Suzuki finds his way back to his feetUsing the seats, the cushy seats of the bullet train.
もうボディスラムとかもしようとしたら足ついちゃいますよね。
そうですね。
JR 東海に怒られる。
パイルドライバーは多分天井に足がつかないとみなされて、OK とされてますが、このパイルドライバーをディフェンスする、まあ、今の高木三四郎のショルダースルーという動きは、あれ鈴木選手の足が天井に届く可能性があったためにレフリーに制止されました。
ブブブブブリトレインフォーライフ、
新幹線が揺れることを対戦相手にアピールしてどうするんですか。全く高木三四郎の有利にことは働いていません。
Man, I bet the food on this train is great.
ああならば汚い手を使いました、高木三四郎です。鈴木みのる余裕ですね。ああだがこうなってくると話は別です。最大のチャンスを、
He's not giving up. They still got a few more stops. Then Shoko Dieno. Don't know him. He's got something. Looks like he's got trail. Well, here we go. Now it's a DDT match.
アイスクリームを売りに来ました。新幹線のね、
はい、
アイスクリーム、そう。
He's got ice cream.
有名なんです。
This is the best transportation experience you could possibly hope for.
硬いんですよ。
Look at that ice cream. It looks delicious.
有名な新幹線の世界一硬い。スジャータ、
これ10月末になくなっちゃいますからね。
そうなんですよ。あれ絶対ダメ、グリーン車は売るんでしたっ
け。 He's got the ice cream in a cold bag。
そんなような話も聞いた気がしますが、まあちょっと簡単にはね、食べられないものになってしまいます。
お客様いかがですか。
チャンスだチャンスだ。
あーその
硬いアイスクリームを使って、硬
いアイスクリーム鈴木みのる、
ダメダメダメ、
うん
食べ物を粗末にしてはいけません。
I'm copying that. We might come down to that.
思わず黙ってしまいました。松井レフリーは怖い顔してますけど、結構こういうのね、厳しい人ですからね。
そうですね。厳しいけど、悪いことに乗っちゃいますよね、結構。
アイスクリームブレイク。
うまい。
お。
バニラ新幹線ます。
This。This is legitimately making me jealous. I actually might go walk to a bodega and buy ice cream after this. Oh my god. That would be awesome! Not only are they all eating ice cream, they're yelling. They're yelling while eating ice cream. Now I'm double jealous.
駅弁を持って帰るって言ってましたけども、どうなんですか、そのご自宅で食べる駅弁の味っていうのは。
Right in the ice hole!
違うもんなんで、こだわりなんですか。
普通に、いろんな種類を
I want ice cream bad. Holy shit. I deserve ice cream. I really might get ice cream after this.
やっぱ一番美味しいのは車窓を眺めながら食べるのだと思います。
そうですね。
そんな時代あったの。
I'm so glad the clips of this that I watched didn't spoil the ice cream or the bear ass.
よく JR とかこんな食ったね。
新幹線スジャータアイスクリーム専用 DDT スプーンですか。
専用なんですか。
専用にしましょうよこの際ですから。マイスプーンを
新幹線に持ち込みましょう。The whole thing too. They're not just taking a bite and wasting it. They are using it.
はい、試合の途中ですが、全員が新幹線のアイスクリームをなぜか売り子さんまで味わっています。
Takagi getting a little towel to get his sweat off like he's Bernie Mac.
突然新幹線内で DDT プロレスのすごいすごい身内の構想を持ち出しましたね。突然この DDT プロレス内男色ヒーローが率いる
フェルノーヒーローと高
木三四郎大社長が
スズキーズゴーインダウン
その身内の構想をいきなり新幹線車内に持ち込んでなぜか鈴木ミノルが巻き込まれています。
Trying to pin him nowDose. these people are having too much fun. Wow, we have seen a lot on this show tonight. We have gone all over the place as far as great matches.
鈴木みのるも大ダメージを負っています。
新幹線ね、富士山とか見えるころじゃない。どっち側だこの野郎、お前知ってんのかおい。
Whatever he said made the crowd go ooh。
天気のいい時はね、とても綺麗な富士山が見ることができます。
今日記念すべき新幹線プロレスで、みんな富士山見たいよな。イエーイ。富士山の中で戦ってる俺ら見たいよな。富士山今から行くか。見えるぞ富士山。あれ富士山だったの。
I wish I knew Japanese just to get these jokes。
行けませんね。過ぎちゃいますか。
We need a little Chris Charlton here。
小玉か光で。
はい。
席変われ。すごい。
What's this? Music?More music and the train.
停車駅でもないんですが、ここでまた車内。
I wish I got my own music when I got on the subway.
これもまた聞いたことがある。
What? A fucking legend, Jun Akiyama, has stepped onto the bullet train.
DDT 名古屋大会がねあるから、やっぱ DDT の選手は選手によっては力で。
Jun Akiyama.
この望み371号シェット買ってたんですかね。
買ったんですかね。
わお。
俺も嫌なんだよこんな新幹線。
嫌だよ。じゃあ俺もバスで行けんじゃねえかよ。
バスは嫌だよこの野郎。嫌だよ。
ベテラン選手はね、バス移動よりかは新幹線移動。
せーの、
ラク選手は、まあ、ツアーで行くときはバスだったり電車だったりするわけですから。できることならやっぱ電車で行くべきだ。
Yoshihiko, who is on the PWP 25.
さすがです。まあでもね、やはり鉄道好きにとっては、
Everybody's against Suzuki。
大会はこの会場にはどうやって行くんだろうなみたいな調べるのも楽しくなる。
おお。
新しい乗ったことない車両にも。
Akiyama's kick。Referee making his way down the aisle for the count。Suzuki squirming away!
Referee も大変です。おお、すぐにブレイクです。これ大変だな。いわゆる通常のプロレスだとね、ブレイクするためのロープが遠いみたいな、そんなシチュエーションがありますけども、この新幹線プロレスは倒れたすぐ横にロープがありますからね。
ありますね。逆に締め技がなかなか決まらないそうで、
はい、あとやっぱ完全にノックアウトしない限り
ジューン holding back。 Oh my god、 He's got the giant fist、
はい、
Is that the mecha mummy fist、
はい、おお、
The giant fist。 Akiyama is down. He's been fisted. Jun Akiyama has been fisted to a permanent end.
Akiyama Jun, というでも500キロのロケットパンチを食らったらひとたまりもありません。
Oh, he's back up. Oh, Akiyama's pissed. Whoa, exploder on the train? I don't think so. Holy shit. Oh, Suzuki's got the fist.
Suzuki Minoru 選手がロケットパンチに興味を示されました。
Clark Griswold, first time chatter, welcome, welcome.
機嫌を損ねてしまった秋山純選手、
空気読め、
帰ってしまいました。ああ
、俺の腕パンチ返せ、こおい、ああ、これは俺の宿敵。
Suzuki's big fist in now.
そうだよ、なんでお前が持ってんだよ。いや、元はと言えば、うちのってなんだよ。
え、
そう、うちのってなんだよ。これ俺のだよ。え、俺のじゃないよ、お前、うちの会社のだ。え、メカマミーって DDT の。そうです。バルシー、バルシー DDT です。そうなんだ。はい。え、そうなんだ。そうです。マジで。あいつ、アマゾンで俺が爆発した。
その後、2回ぐらい復帰して、クリス・ブルックスの興行に勝手に出てます。もう制御不能です。
はい、どのぐらいの人がねついてきてくれているかわかりませんが、このロケットパンチの元々の持ち主、ミイラ型メカレスラー、
Suzuki、
メカマミーについてのモンドが続いています
。高木バックステップ and punch to the face down on his knees, another punch。
今数字ミドルが使って、高木三四郎が絶対絶命の大ピンチです。
I'm so glad we're watching this. I almost took it off for time.Oh, whoa, balking him! Three Stooges style!
Takagi Sanshiro.
Mo!
Shinkansen, ではね、まあ、なるべくね。
This train is zooming, maybe.
Whoa,
who's this? Oh, that's Kazunari Murakami! Kazunari Murakami! I don't know anything about him, I apologize. I am DDT ignorant for the most part, you know that. Oh, he's going after Takagi.
Kazunari 選手じゃないですか。
Man, this dude's... They didn't tell this dude it's a work! Kazunori, it's a work!
Oh!
でしかもこんなね、半裸のプロレスラーが暴れているということで、一般のお客さんやこの車掌さんには手がつけられないので、ちょっとお願いしますと。
ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。ごめんなさい。
まあ、これに関しては村上選手が 100% 正しいです。ああ、マサラ選手が。
Wow. Kazunari making sure no one else gets involved, I suppose. Suzuki attempted to put the fist on his head.
ちょっとあまりこれから騒がないようにしなきゃいけませんね。
先ほどあのなんていうんですかね、掲示板みたいな、はいはい、電光掲示板に新富士駅を通過しているって出てたんですけど、
なるほど、
もう新幹線見えるスポットがどんどん通り過ぎていっちゃってるんです
。I love that this is two old dudes having fun on the train。
もうそれどこじゃないですよ。
それどこじゃないですかね。
あんな怖い人が来たら、富士山見てる
見てる余裕ない。
余裕はないです。
めっちゃ汗かいて、しかも汗で鈴木
さん滑ったからね。絶対 JR で怒られる案件だよ、これ。そうですね、汗で、シートとかを汚してはならないというお達
しができます。Suzuki wiping the sweat off with a towel, Bruce Bruce style. Oh, he's wiping off Takagi!
清掃作業があります
よ。 Look at this! Sportsmanship is alive and well on the bullet train.
濡れた。乾かないですよね。
Oh, now he's choking them. I don't know. I was wondering the same thing. I think they got to know the big beats. They got to know the big beats of the people that are boarding the train and everything, I suppose. Oh, what is that? Is that a book?
定番中の定番じゃないですか、ラクさん。
これは新横浜駅で買ってきたんですかね。
What's in the box, or is that a book?
横浜名物でもありますし、まあ、東京駅、品川駅にももちろん売っています。
Oh, it's food! It's got some chopsticks now. Some disposable chopsticks.
絶対に外さないですからね。ラクさんはどうでしょう、なんか。これっていうお弁当ありますか？新幹線で食べられる。
This is making me hungry.
これのあのチャーハンバージョン。
わかります。
I'm hungry now.
チャーハン弁当。
はい、絶対チャーハン派ですよ。
あ、Suzuki eating ice cream and then sushi。
シュウマイが食べたいんで。
それもわかります。はい、
でもしくは私のおすすめはですね。これね、基礎レフリー、DDT と東京女子をさばいているレフリーの基礎さんに聞いたんですが、あの海賊紙弁当ってあるじゃないですか、品川海賊紙弁当、あれがですね、ビールのおつまみに最高なんですよ、はい、いい感じに甘辛の味付けがしてあ
って、鈴木 sitting down on an armrest。Once again, there's so much room on this train。
つまむ感じで、これがやってみたら抜群でした。お酒を飲める方はぜひ試してみてください。
そっか、じゃあ夜にお酒飲みながら新幹線乗って。
なんだったらそう新幹線でもいいし、ラク選手のように海賊紙弁当を持ち帰って晩酌に使ってもよし。
法的には企業権にも怒られる。あ、やばい。確かにそうだ。
試合中にいところでお弁当食べて大丈夫なんですかね、鈴木選手。結構一生懸命夢中になって食べてますね。
Suzuki finishing his dinner。
早めにするとね、やっぱダメなんで。
これはいわゆるもぐもぐタイムという
やつですね。These guys are
now having a break. とごくごくタイム。
Taking a little break. Water. Dinner.
Oh, yeah, 小田原は。
Oh my God. This is the part I've seen, but.
でかくて怖い車掌さんなんですが。
God damn, Kenta Kobashi is on the bullet train.
でも新幹線。 線でこんななりのね車掌さんがね切符を拝見しに来ることは最近ないんですよね。
ないですね、ええ、西江社長さん
でも導入行ってますね。
ケンセクバーシ
いいですよね。
Punching people's tickets。
確かに。
He
いいですね。
is a legend。
はい。
He is a fucking legend, and he's doing this that makes him even more of a legend。
オフィシャルマークみたいな。スタンプがついてるとダクさんのサイン本物ですよ。てか小橋健太さんじゃないですか。小橋健太さんですよ。あれどう見ても。
Fighting。Hey! That's the ticket taker, but it's also Kenta Kobashi. We're a couple minutes away to this being the longest episode we've done.
他のお客様に迷惑をかける客には逆水平チョップを食らわす車掌さんです。
Oh shit! Kobashi! He loves it! Look at his face!
Kobashi-san! 二次災害です。
Once again, I wish I knew Japanese. These guys are probably hilarious. Get his ass. Oh, smacked him. Got a little high. Couple fingers touched the throat on that chop. There goes the fucking legend, Kenta Kobashi. This is really amazing.Wow. He's fucking over. Yes, his song's playing.
Oh my god. So it's a lot of people on
this one.
This is amazing.
This is amazing. This is amazing.大小橋コールに見送られながら今16号車を後にします。ああそこに収まりがつかない鈴木乃が立ちはだかる。さっと小橋健太車掌の表情が変わって強制的に排除です。
Goodbye, everyone. I'm going to the other car. The Showtime dancers on the L train wish they got that response.
さあ、試合再開になるんでしょうか。何か企んでいます鈴木みのる。何か持ってますね。あ。これはゴングを鳴らす用の木槌ですね。あ、なぜか正田武史、
さっき村
上さんに連れて行かれた正田武史のタオルということは、このタオルの持ち主の方は名古屋に到着したらそのまま名古屋国際会議場に行って DDT の大会を
観戦するつもりですね。Advancing with a mallet in his hand.
結構全員行きそうです
よね。そうですよね。これ見たらね。
He's broken him in the
head.
Those mallet shots are brutal! Referee with the mallet now.
He's
going to put it somewhere. Choking out Takagi. Chin breaker. Caught by Suzuki. Choking him out. Oh, shit. Got style. Pile. Holding him up. Pile. Driver. On the floor. Pinfall. One, two, three. Wow. What a main event. That was amazing. That was amazing, and it was worth going over, because I don't know if I would have watched this on my own. I like watching stuff on the show. Great crowd too. Great crowd. And they really, they did a lot, man. They did a lot to fill 42 minutes, our longest non-battle royal match that we've ever watched on this show.
Nozomi.
また負けた。はい、負けました。また負けた。また負けた。鈴木だね。なんだ。鈴木だね。鈴木さん。鈴木さん。ありがとうございました。
Yeah. Look at this. Look at that train, it's going so fast, I can't believe it. What a show. For real. I mean it. What a show. We started off with an amazing Buzzbin tag team match. We went all over the place. This was a good one. Thank you, everybody. Thanks for the submissions. Always taking submissions. Send them on over. If this is your first time watching, give me a follow. We do this every week. Follow me on other things. That's how I communicate with people. And one thing I wanted to say before I go, I was talking to Owen Straw about this. It's hard to pick the Buzzbin matches on this show because it's, you know, they keep coming, and you lose one week and things are gone forever. So he came up with an idea that I ran with. I'm going to do random shows sometimes. It's going to be a weekend, you know, some weekend night, or maybe even wake up in the morning and just watch some Buzz stuff. So follow me. Make sure you get an alert when I go online. Because I have, I'll show you right here. I got an all Buzz show that we can do at any time. It's gonna be more casual than this, but it's literally just gonna be like, hey, I have a couple hours, I got nothing to do. Who wants to watch something? I have Buzzbin matches up the yin yang, let's do it. So it's gonna be something like that. So just follow me. And make sure that you, know what's up. So, yeah, that's that. And, yeah. So, thank you, everybody. This has been a great one. I feel good about it. And so yeah, keep in touch. I have a last week's gimmick episode was a lot of fun. I got a lot of good feedback from it. New people checking out the show, which is always great. I have three ideas for future gimmick shows. One of them I've had forever. The religious episode that the Suzanimal has sent me a lot of great stuff for, and I dug up some stuff too. And I almost abandoned it just because I didn't want religious people to get mad at me, but now I don't care, and now I have a hook and I have an idea for it. So we got the religious episode. I mentioned it last week, the optimized for YouTube episode, whatever that means to you. Make an episode that's for YouTube, you know what I mean? We'll figure stuff out for that. And another one that I'm not even going to mention right now. So that's that. You guys have been great. I have been Scotland Green. That's our show. Thank you, everybody. And thank you for being so beautiful.